It's your boy, Blushing Boy, ladies and gentlemen.
They may be described as ethical and as spiritual, not necessarily religious. The principles of modern humanism are based on respect for honesty and for truth and for a caring attitude towards other people and the environment. They're ones that they fully share along with Superman. This celebration of marriage will reflect and encompass their views and their feeling of an affinity with the natural world, of which we as humans are part of. As well as having a rather serious part of the day, we also hope that you'll remember it as being fun and very enjoyable. Now, Helen did tell me that she's been on a diet before the wedding, not that she needed to. It was Martin's idea. It's a slightly odd diet, consisting predominantly of coconut and banana. Now, she hasn't lost any weight, but fuck, she can really climb a tree now. we stand under the picture of this wonderful tree here. Trees from ancient times have been used as a symbolic meaning, irrespective of whichever culture you come from. Now, we're beneath an oak. In Roman times, the Romans believed that oaks were a conduit for lightning that came from the sky, and subsequently associated to Jupiter, the god of sky. His wife, being Juno, is the god of marriage. So this basically is the symbolising of the fulfilment and conjugal fertility. Helen and Martin are now going to light one candle each. They may not work and they may well probably blow out, which doesn't mean that the marriage is going to fail terribly. It just means that it's rather windy.
Yeah. I see the light.
Now these candles, they stand for the individual lives of Helen and Martin. The third candle in front will be lit a little bit later on. The mutual commitment of Helen and Martin has developed since they met about 7 years ago. They remained friends for many years, both satisfied, content and happy in their separate lives. That seems a shame to spoil it, doesn't it? However, last bank holiday at the festival, Festabilly, their love suddenly blossomed, and 1 year later they stand in front of you here, openly declaring their love for each other.
Great! Yeah.
Serious lovey bit now. To marry is to form an equal partnership, freely entered into by the bonds of emotion, love and reason. Yeah, I know you certainly are. It is the most most fragile of relationships, and also the strongest. It's fragile because it requires a right balance of freedom and interdependence, of caring and of sharing, of being together and of being alone. It is strong because it involves the mysterious force of something we know as love. Mutual devotion, concern for the happiness of each other, and joy in each other's company. That's the wishy-washy bit. Marriage is a bond only to be entered after considerable thought and reflection, and occasionally considerable alcohol. As with all aspects of life, it has its cycles, its ups and its downs, its triumphs and its trials. With the understanding of this, Martin and Helen are entering into this contract of marriage. Now, they have already completed the legal ceremony in Sri Lanka, which some of you may well have been at, only a couple of you, I believe, where they first discovered a mutual love of elephants, which is a bit weird. Depends what sort of love it is. Now, Helen and I did spend some time talking about this at length last night, as whether they were African or Indian, depending on the size of their ears. We've come to the conclusion that we believe Martin to be African.
See those pockets now, hey!
In Sri Lanka, they also exchange rings. Now, a wedding ring is a circle. It symbolizes wholeness and it symbolizes strength, cooperation and peace. It looks inwardly toward the wearer and externally towards the external world. We're now going to come for the hand fasting. Oh, thank you. So you can untie that. Thank you very much, Lee. I'll need that bit, otherwise they're already done. Now we come to the hand fasting. It's a ritual steeped in Roman tradition. It was commonplace. It's practiced in many cultures, linking the hands together as a kind of permanent handshake. The term is derived from a custom of tying the broom, and the hands together. Now, hand fasting ribbons have a variety of different meanings. This is a plait of four different cords. They mean something to Helen and Martin specifically. Would you like to place some jump off? Helen, if you can repeat after me. I enter this marriage with you. Knowing that the true magic of love. Not to avoid changes. But navigate them successfully. I enter this marriage with you, knowing that the true magic of love is not to avoid changes, but to navigate them successfully. Strengthened by the binding of your hands. Also, let them be a reminder that you have participated in a ritual of ancient times and which has been used by thousands of people going back in history. You may wish to preserve those ribbons. You may wish to preserve these ribbons as a reminder of the vows you've taken today. From the two candles, Martin and Helen will now light the third candle to symbolise the joining of their lives. This candle is a mark of the unity and another symbol of the vows they've exchanged today. The other two candles will obviously remain alight to represent their continued individuality. Well, in the presence... Oh, you can't do a minute. Starting. Well, over to the fat man sing. In the presence of their friends and their families, Martin and Helen have made vows and confirmed their marriage by hand fasting. So I think it might be time, but we've already done it, to watch a merry kiss. In a moment, the way to reception to officialise their union, Helen and Martin's final ritual will be the jumping of a broom. I'm going to place this here, don't do it just yet.
you want to hammer that thing. It's quite high. It is.
I did actually ask beforehand if we could do a cop joke, because all good rituals start with cop jokes. I understand that Martin was wandering through the arena yesterday and he found a little bottle with a genie in it. And he rubbed it and the genie said, "What would you like?" He said, "I'd like my cock to be able to touch the floor." And his legs fell off.
And then I came back.
At the bus, you will all have an opportunity, those guests are invited, not the hangers-on that have turned up. You will have an opportunity to write down your messages of love and goodwill on some little pieces of fabric that Helen's got for you, and they're all going to be tied together to get a signification of the bond. We offer you, Martin, and obviously Helen, our heartfelt good wishes. May you have joy and give joy. May the quality of your home be the source of strength and happiness. May your happiness and strength be passed on to others. May life smile on you, and may you achieve fulfillment in your life together. If you've got a partner, even if you haven't, just join hands very quickly. We're going to quickly recite a Celtic ritual. Everybody join hands, it doesn't matter. Make sure they haven't just come out of the Waterloos. Are you all there? This is a traditional Celtic benediction. Peace, are you all there? Peace of the running water to you. The peace of the flowing air to you. The peace of the quiet earth to you. The peace of the shining stars to you.
I'm looking at the light. So wonderful, thank you.
You might have better luck than I do. My fingers aren't doing this very well.